So what's your name?
My name is Divya Bhavsar.
Now you answer in a very professional way.
My life's philosophy is to literally just do what I feel like doing in a particular moment. That's how I started being creative. When I was a kid, I started making clothes for my dolls because I felt like making those clothes. So that's how everything has started in my life, because I literally felt like doing it. So,
what do you do?
I am a designer. I make clothes, I teach fashion illustration, and I paint. So I'm in, yeah.
What do you call yourself?
An artist. I'm an artist because I create.
Okay, tell me one thing. Have you thought about that question?
When? Right now?
In life.
What I am?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Because earlier I thought that what you are is just defined by what you study. I mean, you know, I'm a graduate in fashion designing. So I've studied fashion designing. So earlier I used to call myself a fashion designer. But after that I started teaching and I started painting. So I realized that, I mean, you are not just what you study. So that's why I would prefer to call myself an artist.
So, since when have you been doing this?
I started painting 2.5 years ago.
Oh, that's relatively very recent.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
I keep thinking that whoever does what they do, they've been doing it for 15 years. Like, whoever I meet.
Yeah.
So, how did you get into painting?
So, I used to enjoy drawing as a kid, and because I wanted to become a designer, I gave elementary and intermediate examinations, and I think those examinations actually developed my drawing and painting skills quite a bit. But I used to mainly draw garments and clothes. In just 2.5 years ago, I had gone to I'd been to Austria for a trip, and I came back and I was going through my vacation pictures, and I just had an urge to draw one of those pictures. Like, I started with sketching, not even painting. But while sketching that picture, I started imagining it as Kashmir, because I have loved the mountains a lot since forever. And so for me, the mountains are my muse. All the love that I have for the mountains just comes out in the form of these paintings on my canvas. It just kind of flows on the canvas.
What's the most common emotion that you go through while painting?
Okay, yeah. So Rumi is a poet, and he was in love with this man called Shams-e Tabriz. And I read a lot of Rumi, and I just feel that all the love I have for the mountains. So when I think of me and the mountains, it feels like I am into a Romeo and Juliet movie or a Leila and Majnu movie. So it's like I'm the Majnu and I'm the Romeo, and I'm just like appreciating the mountains, appreciating the beauty, and just. So painting for me is that appreciation that I have for nature and mountains. So, that's the emotion I go through, the emotion of love mainly, and not just love, but madness mainly, love and madness.
What does the painting day look like?
I start by 4 and I go up till 10, because I feel that's when I'm the most productive. I don't know why I've started painting in the day. I've tried to paint in the day also, which is nice. I mean, obviously if I have my favorite music, I can obviously keep doing it. But in the evenings, I can actually do it with all my concentration. And especially when it starts getting darker, I think I get some different energy, maybe from the moon, I don't know what. But one very important thing that I need around me before I start painting is cleanliness. I cannot paint when, like, in an unclean environment. So I actually do all the dusting of my room every single day. And there are days when I decide that today I won't waste my time doing that, because I just won't have to paint a lot, but I still try to just...
The basic.
Yeah, end up doing something or the other. And then I try to light some agarbatti just for some fragrance, because I think that just puts me in a very relaxed mood.
Right.
And I play A.R. Rahman songs, and I think of the mountains and I paint.
How do you decide the subject of your painting?
So usually I go through my pictures. I mean, that's what I like to do, because whatever pictures I've myself clicked, whenever I look at a picture and if I feel like painting the picture, I do it. So in this particular painting, I have to show the effect of sunlight, which I've never done before. So I'm actually not sure how it is going to turn out. If it doesn't turn out, it's okay. I will not do that, but I just want to try that. So in each and every painting of mine till now, there has been some or the other new element that I've tried experimenting with. So,
like a challenge of sorts.
Yeah, that's a challenge, because otherwise, apart from that, it's just nature that I'm painting. So for it to not get monotonous, I think unconsciously, I end up choosing such pictures which are a little different than the previous picture I've painted.
A little demanding in a way.
Yeah, exactly.
Novel,
yeah.
And how do you practice and how often?
I honestly prefer creating every day. So if I have painting orders, That's the, I mean, the best thing to do, because it's like I have a deadline. I've given some deadline to the client. So then I have to do it every day. But the times when I don't have orders, I still try to paint at least for 3 hours a day, every single day.
What inspires you?
Nature. Mainly mountains, but nature. If I'm not painting the mountains, it has to be something which is green.
Around the mountain then.
Yeah. Or actually, I do end up painting and sketching a lot of roads. Like, I love roads which are covered with trees. Roads and also houses. Like, these are the three elements: greenery, houses and roads. So I think the house kind of indicates the fact that I feel at home when I'm in the mountains. When I think of the mountains, yeah, even if I'm not in the mountains, just the thought is enough to just calm me down and relax me no matter what mood I am in.
Who do you look up to?
Mountains and nature. There's not a particular person that I can look up to.
Tell us something about this painting.
So this is a road which is going into the mountains. A lot of my answers might be very similar to each other. But that's what I'm painting, and it's from my recent trip. So I'm just kind of reliving that memory, because this was a very beautiful, quiet road. And we walked a lot. I think we walked for like 1 or 2 hours continuously. And that was one of the most beautiful memories of the trip. So
do you have any goals with paintings as such?
Okay, my literal goal is to keep painting or keep creating till I die. Like, even if I'm 100 and if I'm physically able to paint, I want to keep painting. I don't literally have those goals, but I want to achieve a particular thing. I don't care about that. I just want to keep doing what I do for my happiness.
What questions do you get asked the most?
People ask me how much time I've taken for a particular painting. That's a very common question that people ask me, I think, because they look at it and they're like, oh, isko bahut time laga hoga, kitna time laga? That's the only thing they ask.
And are they happy with your answer?
I think they don't care. They just ask for the sake of asking once. They're just, asking.
There's nothing else to ask. They don't want to know.
It doesn't really matter, no, in the end to them,
right.
Honestly.
Right. What's the average time it takes to finish one painting?
It mainly depends on the size of the painting and the amount of detailing that has gone into it. Okay, so the one that I'm doing right now has taken about 5 to 6 hours. And if it's a bigger painting, if it's this
point,
painting,
point.
This took 1.5 months.
You can sit there, I'll take a different shot later.
Okay, this took around 1.5 months because it has too much detailing. Okay, there's a lot of trees and too many colors.
Right.
Too many smaller, finer strokes also.
Got it.
I think this one again took 2-3 days. This one again took 1 month.
Now when you say 2-3 days, of how much time per
hour? Yeah, per
day?
Per day, around 5 hours per day.
5 to 4 hours.
5 to 6, I was going to say, but then I thought that's too much.
Piece of advice for those wanting to become painters?
Well, I don't know if I can give any advice for this, because I think when I'm painting, it's the music that's painting. I think it's not me who's painting it. Like, I don't know. I'm just like an invisible person at that moment. I'm not there when I'm painting. It's just the music, the emotions that the music is trying to express that is actually turning my painting into what it is.
So you're just the membrane through which the art...
Yes, definitely. I don't think I can ever teach anyone how to paint. I teach illustration, fashion illustration, because that involves technicalities. But this, according to me, doesn't need any technicalities.
Give me a quote which has some association with painting as such.
So this quote I really love. It's from the Dead Poets Society.
Mm-hmm.
It's by Robin Williams. Obviously, it's one of the most famous quotes. What business, medicine, law and engineering, these are necessary pursuits to sustain life, but beauty, romance, love and poetry, these are what we stay alive for. Hi, I'm Divya Bhavsar and you're watching The Meet Series.